Hello, welcome back to another video. I decided to just start filming now because it's been another really hot day, as you can probably tell from how sweaty I am. But we've just had this cloud rolling in and it rained for about 10 minutes. And then we have lots of thunder going on. So this is our third summer here and we're yet to experience summer storms. This may be the year we get to experience them. I'm actually getting rained on very slightly. It's not enough to water the garden, but it's pretty exciting for us. We got the laundry in.
Mm.
In the storm. Well, that definitely ended up being enough to water the garden, which is lovely, and the smell is just incredible. It's still about 30 degrees and it's just like this humid petrichor. But what's really strange is we've just had all that rain for about an hour and now there's a huge fire and just a few villages along we can see all the smoke. There's two water planes flying around, so it's kind of like this weird contrast of just been raining, so I don't know why there's a fire, but it's a lot of smoke and it looks really weird with this cloud in the sun. This fire's looking pretty big and bad. I think there's 8 aerial resources. Is that right, Ian? And so we're gonna go for our dog walk, and normally we can look into the valley. We can see the Gdynia to see if we can see the plains and the fire. We won't be getting too close, don't worry. But... Is it a magpie?
Yeah.
Where do you think his nest is?
I don't know. What do we do?
I don't know.
I feel like it's a sitting magpie if we just leave it somewhere. He's not got any tail feathers, look.
Oh yeah.
That's why he can't fly. I reckon he's been had by a cat or something.
There's no blood on him though.
Frank pooped on that. You definitely can't fly.
There's dogs everywhere as well.
If we keep this little guy alive. Right, look. He's loving it.
Well, this is probably one of the wildest Sunday afternoons I've ever lived through. We've put Mr. Magpie in here. Try and keep him away from the cats, and now need to Google Albi know how to look after a baby magpie. Yeah, there's a fox that lives in that road. I've seen him a few times, so I figured he didn't have a chance.
And it's not the first bird I've rescued.
No. When we met, Iwan had a seagull called George.
One day George will turn up here, I'm sure of it.
Do you think dog food?
Why not?
I don't know.
Adult ones eat cat food.
Yeah, okay.
So this is not very much dog food at all, mixed with water. So
put the cover over because the cats are just harassing him.
Sorry, Joao. Do some googling on how to rescue magpies.
And there's still a bit of leftover smoke in the sky, but it seems to have gone out over there. So I think there were 10 planes in the end, hoping they've got that under control. Last video I was saying we had the Canadian wildfire smoke over us, and I was thinking it's not long till we'll have our own, so first fire that we've had so close. Straight after the rain, which is very strange. But yeah, thank goodness we have these people flying these planes.
Different bottom or? Oh, you mean in the gap? Yeah, okay. Ready? Should we go straight to the cabin? Right, towards me. I can go sideways, it's probably best, but.
Good morning. So we have made a plan to put the pump in this old reservoir. We have tried to fix this reservoir before because it would be a really nice water tank to keep cooling in the summer, but we cannot fix the leak. There's a problem with this corner, so we're going to actually knock this corner out to put a door in and try and build this up to be a building where we can store the water pump and then eventually our solar batteries and a gas bottle, maybe.
Utility room.
Yes, that's the word.
Pumping house. This one.
I'm going to show you these funny spiders, so look away if you don't like spiders. So I think they're actually not technically a spider, like species-wise, but they you get them in like groups of hundreds. I don't know if they're picking up on the camera because they're so thin, but they kind of like dance. Get them everywhere. Strange creatures.
Very strange. I had no idea they weren't spiders.
Yeah, I'm sure when I tried to Google about them, or maybe I saw it on that wildlife in Portugal Facebook group. So we got some new filters, one for sediment and one for smell to put on, and some of you know our shower was not working, and we think it was because there's too much pressure going in from this pump, so we went to go buy a pressure reduction valve, but the guy in the shop did say this may reduce the pressure enough by putting the filter on. So we're going to try that first, see if it works. We're going to cut it, yeah?
Yeah.
Get another small piece of
paper. But it doesn't bend, does it? The black pipe goes straight.
Yeah.
It doesn't bend.
So it'll just be in there, yeah?
And the rubber thing. I know exactly what I'm doing.
I think what we should do then is set up the tap where we want it, and then create the connection from there. Okay. It's actually really hot.
Yeah. The flies are the worst.
The wall when we build it, so maybe we go with someone here if we can get the post in the ground.
It's like turning into rock.
Yeah.
If you flip the pipe over to this side, then it'll loosen it. That's why it's had to go over there, because that's loose, see? It's how much resembling Niagara Falls it's going to be.
Close the clock
again,
Philip.
You got that screwdriver. You got one little leak there at the end.
Yeah.
So I'm going to move this maybe this way or something. Taking this little guy to the GNR, which is the Garde Nationale. Apparently that's where you should take injured birds this morning. I'd just like to take a quick minute to thank the sponsor of today's video, which is Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one website building platform where it's easy to create a beautiful website. If you're a creative, a solo entrepreneur, or a business owner with a large team, then Squarespace can empower you to create a powerful online presence, engage with your audience, and sell anything, whether it's a product, your content, all your time all in one place. Let me tell you about some of the features they have which make creating a website with them a smooth experience. Firstly, I love their beautiful award-winning templates. They have more than 100 beautiful designs to choose from, and they quickly help you to achieve a sleek and professional looking site, even if this is your first time creating one. Secondly, they have a new editing interface called Fluid Engine, where you can simply drag and drop to easily position everything exactly the way you want. This allows you to customize every design detail, placing text and images exactly where you would like. And finally, their commerce feature makes it simple to set up an online store, and they now offer custom merch to help you scale your brand. All you need to do is design your products. The production, inventory, and shipping are all handled for you by Squarespace to save you time and money. You'll find a link to squarespace.com in the description below, which you can head to for a free trial. And when you're ready to launch, you can save 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain by going to squarespace.com/FrankieOffGrid.
Hello, everybody. It's been a hot day again. Surprise, surprise. But it has been quite a bit cooler than it was yesterday after having all the rain. So that's not too bad. So I'm going to get some more shoveling done. This morning we did manage to get to the GNR office in our local town, who very kindly, very friendly, very easily took our little charneco, the Iberian magpie. So they took it. God knows what they'll do with it. I can only assume they'll do something helpful and useful. They did take our name, the location we found it, and our phone number. So I assume that's for like where they'll release it or something, but fingers crossed. So it didn't get eaten by a cat, which is always good. I don't think a flightless bird around here with all the cats and the mongoose and the gennets and all the other things that would quite happily eat a very small, helpless bird. Yeah, anyway, get some shoveling done. still plenty sweaty. I think it's still about 30 degrees. It's definitely quite warm still. For those of you that are new here, firstly, welcome. I thought I'd let you know what we're actually doing, because I've realised we've not mentioned it in a couple of videos. So we're actually filling in the driveway. This is the current driveway. We're going for a permanent driveway. It's the closest part to the house, which is up there behind me. There somewhere, it's about 50 metres away. So, yeah, we need to get this all filled in because the incline's a bit too sharp, especially in winter when it's raining and stuff. So we're using what is left of the old kitchen floor to fill it all in. And hopefully it'll be enough. But if not, we'll have to start working on the barn floor. So, silver linings and all. Quick on.
Sorry.
Good morning. It was kind of freezing this morning when we woke up. It was about 15 degrees, and yeah, for summer that's just lovely to wake up to. Even had to put a jumper on. Iwan has gone out on an early strim, gone to strim some fields, and I'm going to clear up around here. We moved the water pump into this area yesterday, and I'm still not awake. I've not had a cup of tea yet. can't get my words out. So I'm going to clear up around here. We're installing something this weekend. We'll be putting out a little extra midweek video showing you that, so I need to kind of clear up around here. It's gotten very overgrown. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do before it gets too hot. It's actually, so last week we had the first like heat wave of the summer. We call them thermometer days because on the weather app they have a little thermometer sign rather than the sun. It's just thermometer. I think it's because it's a heat weather warning. We haven't got any of those for about 10 days, so it's like kind of like steadily sitting in the early 30s. I think it's about going to get up to 30 today, so it's quite cool for us for the summer. So far, really enjoying this summer. Our first two summers were just really difficult because we just didn't have the infrastructure. We didn't have like the indoor places to escape to. But now the kitchen, we can actually sit in there. We've got under the lean-to. We're managing to keep the cabin cooler because we bought a mosquito net, which means we can leave the door open all day. Yeah, and just kind of like embracing the slowness of the afternoons to just read and draw and chill. Some escaped chickens. I'm gonna put them in before they destroy my garden. And then we'll do some sorting out. Hey Diogo, and a cup of tea. Oh, thank you.
Diogo, have a lot to say this morning.
This all smells really amazing. I think it's a marjoram. Maybe I will dry some of it in the greenhouse. A lot of ants here. Who come to help? sky. It's probably why I shouldn't be wearing sandals. They can give a pretty nasty bite, apparently.
Albi's in the front seat.